Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for Autumn 2015. Neutral ENSO conditions are likely for the next couple of months, but El Niño still can't be ruled out for this winter. Our temperature outlooks point towards a warmer autumn, while rainfall outlooks suggest we shouldn't bank on an early autumn break. But first, let's look at recent conditions. Parts of southern Australia only had half their usual summer rainfall. Perth had a long dry spell, 61 days without a drop of rain. But many areas had a wetter than expected summer. For inland Australia, much of that rain came in the first 2 weeks of January. These January rains meant some regions saw a rise in their soil moisture. However, many areas still have dry, deep soils. This means drought conditions persist, particularly in Queensland and Western Victoria. While both states had summer rains, unfortunately, not enough fell in the places that needed them most. Summer felt cooler in the east than in recent years, mainly due to fewer days of extreme heat. But daytime temperatures were actually average to warmer than average. In the west, WA had one of its hottest summers on record, setting records for the latest 49 degree day and Australia's hottest February night. The hot and dry set the stage for bushfires to rage in the southwest for weeks, so long that firefighters from other states flew in to offer relief. The tropical cyclone season had a late but dramatic start. Only twice on record have we gone so far through the season without a coastal crossing, but on the 20th of February, two cyclones made landfall. TC Lam hit the top end at Category 4, then just hours later, TC Marsha crossed the Queensland coast at Category 5, the strongest on our scale. Looking ahead, let's see what may drive our climate in the coming months. Our ENSO tracker remains at neutral. However, several models suggest the tropical Pacific Ocean may once again shift towards El Niño by the winter. Model accuracy isn't as high at this time of year, so we'll be keeping a close eye on any further developments. The other key driver in autumn and early winter is the location of the high pressure systems, known as the subtropical ridge. In recent years, the highs have been further south. That has made it harder for fronts and weather systems to bring rain to southern Australia, as shown by the orange and red areas on this map. Turning now to the rainfall outlook for autumn as a whole, wetter than average conditions appear likely in northern Western Australia and also central Australia. But if we focus in on March, odds favour wetter conditions for parts of Queensland and northern New South Wales, but these odds weaken for the southern states. Given the long-term trends in southern Australian rainfall, this suggests an early autumn break is less likely. These outlooks both have moderate accuracy. In terms of stream flow, the January rains are now heading down some of our waterways. The February to April stream flow outlook suggests low flows are likely at 27 locations, median flows at 25, and high at just 6. Accuracy for our stream flow forecast is high at this time of year. Moving on to temperature, the outlooks for autumn indicate warmer than average days and nights for most of Australia. Accuracy for these outlooks is moderate to high at this time of year. With the warm and dry persisting past the end of summer, bushfire risk remains for southern Australia. So in summary, a warmer than normal autumn and an early break looking less likely. Low to medium stream flows are expected across eastern Australia. The bushfire risk remains for the south and cyclones remain possible in the north. For more details, head to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 26th of March. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.